It is my privilege on behalf of the Diocese of Raleigh to give some historical perspective about the land in which we sit today, and especially those individuals who have done so much with such great faith to get us to where we are today. We start with the city of Raleigh in the late 1800s. What you see there is a map from 1872. The layout of the city will be somewhat familiar to you, and the street names will be familiar, but much has changed with our city. To give you a sense of where you are on that map, in the center is the Capitol building. And just down the street, on Hillsborough Street, is the future site of Sacred Heart Cathedral. In the late 1800s, there was no Diocese of Raleigh, no diocese at all in the state of North Carolina. In fact, in the late 1800s in North Carolina, there were only 500 Catholics in the entire state, many fewer than are here in this tent today. It wasn't until 1924 that Sacred Heart Church became Sacred Heart Cathedral, when we had 6,000 Catholics in the state of North Carolina. But even then, Sacred Heart Cathedral was known as a small church. Bishop McGinnis was fond of saying that his cathedral was the only cathedral in the United States where he could sit at the cathedral next to the altar and greet parishioners as they came through the front door. Where we are here today is just off the bottom of the map where it says Raleigh. This land where we are today was known as Spring Hill. It was a predominantly African-American community in the late 1800s. It's an elevated spot. It's the highest spot in the city at about 400 feet, dotted with farms and small communities. This is where our story starts today. In 1868, James Gibbons was, as bishop, the vicar apostolic of North Carolina. We would later know him as Cardinal Gibbons. And even though he was centered in Wilmington, he traveled throughout the state doing missionary work. There was a young man who accompanied him on many of these trips and also served as an acolyte for him at his masses. That young man in 1886 would be ordained a Catholic priest, the first native-born North Carolinian to become a priest, Father Thomas Price. We know him as the Tar Heel Apostle, and his cause for beatification and canonization was opened in 2012 by the Diocese of Raleigh. Father Thomas Price served in New Bern for 9 years, but traveled across the state spreading the news of the Catholic faith. That work eventually led him here to be stationed in Raleigh in the late 1800s. In order to do his missionary work, he soon found it important to purchase property that could serve as the headquarters for his work throughout the state. And so that brought him here to this property. It must have been a strange sight, a Catholic priest. None of the members of the community had ever seen a Catholic priest before. He walked up to the first woman that he found, and he said he intended to purchase this property to use it as the base for spreading Catholic faith across the state of North Carolina. She looked at him. Obviously, he had no resources, nothing to speak of, and she said, "How do you plan to do that?" He answered very simply, "With the grace of God and with faith." And so it happened. Father Thomas Price was able to purchase 400 acres on this property of Spring Hill, which quickly became known as Nazareth. His first order of business in 1899 was the founding of Nazareth Orphanage. This picture was taken some years later and shows the campus, a variety of buildings, boys and girls dormitories, a housing for clergy and religious, even the Nazareth Post Office. In the center, you'll see a chapel. This is a picture from the 50s. You see Western Boulevard in the foreground, and in the upper right, you see the Nazareth property. For many years, the Nazareth Orphanage along the skyline from Raleigh was one of the most distinct features you would see, and the steeple on the chapel was visible at all times from downtown Raleigh. This is a close-up of that view of the Nazareth property in the 50s. But back to the chapel. The chapel was founded by Father Thomas Price. Its name, Holy Name of Jesus Chapel. For those children who grew up at the orphanage, the chapel was central to their memories. This chapel was the place they went to daily mass, where they prayed. Holy Name of Jesus Chapel was central to their home. In the mid-1940s, Bishop Waters was installed as the third bishop of Raleigh. And quickly, he integrated the Diocese of Raleigh in the early 1950s, making Cathedral Latin High School in downtown Raleigh the first integrated high school in the state of North Carolina. Bishop Waters shared with Father Price a missionary zeal and a desire to spread the faith to all members of North Carolina. And so he moved Cathedral Latin High School in 1962 to this property, renaming the school Cardinal Gibbons High School. It remained here on this property until 1999, when Bishop Gossman and the Franciscan Brothers of Brooklyn moved it to its present-day location on Edwards Mill Boulevard. This is a picture of the campus here on the Nazareth property. Bishop Waters and Bishop Gossman both spoke about a new cathedral. It was Bishop Waters' desire that a cathedral be built and that it be built here to fulfill Father Price's vision. And Bishop Gossman, upon the installation of Bishop Burbage, remarked to Bishop Burbage, "What I have left to you is the building of a cathedral." Here we are today. This is one of the buildings that once stood on this site. As you know, the buildings from this site have been removed, but they do live on. This is the Father Price gym here at the Nazareth property that was used by Cardinal Gibbons High School. The gym lives on as a pavilion on the current campus in Edwards Mill, and the floor has been repurposed throughout the school. The Catholic Center stood on this site for many years, and visitors and staff people every day passed by a statue of our mother. It came from the grotto at the orphanage, and it rested on a base, a stone, that was the cornerstone of the original orphanage in 1899. That statue and that cornerstone had been moved to the new Catholic Center in North Raleigh. The reuse of these items is more than just a memory. It's a reminder to all of us that we are carrying out a legacy, a vision that came before us and that we push forward. That brings us to today. This is a shot overhead of what this property looks like today, bordered by Western Boulevard to the north, Centennial to the south, Nazareth to the west. You see the streets, Price Street, Agnes Street. That was named after Father Thomas Price's sister. This is pretty close to what we look like today, and the circle is where all of us sit right now. We're sitting in the precise location of the Holy Name of Jesus Cathedral. So today, for the first time, we get to envision and actually see pictures of what this cathedral will look like from exactly where we are sitting today. We start at the back. From where you entered from the back of the tent, you enter through the narthex. You'll enter underneath a choir loft, a brand new organ that's being designed specifically for the space. You'll pass by the baptismal font, and you will enter in and see the full cathedral. To your left and to your right, you will see the ambulatories and the arches that lead to those. Installed in those will be our Stations of the Cross, but they're not new. They were built 80 years ago. They come from St. Francis Parish in Philadelphia, and they're absolutely beautiful. For a sense of scale, they're each over 5 feet tall and will be installed down both sides of the cathedral. As you move further into the nave, the next thing that you will see are the stained glass windows, again, on your left and right in the ambulatories. These come from the Ascension of Our Lord Parish, also in Philadelphia. They were designed in the late 20s. Many of them were designed by Paula Bolano. She was the first woman to open up her own firm that designed and manufactured, produced all of these stained glass windows, again, in the late 1920s. For a sense of scale, that center window is over 18 feet tall, nearly as tall as the peak of this tent. Coming closer towards the sanctuary, you will see the dome at the center of the cathedral. Mr. Jim O'Brien, our architect, reminds us that the word dome comes from the Latin word domus, which means home. And it's at this point that we know that we are home. This picture is a perspective from the height of the dome down on the sanctuary, and you can see its position above the altar and the main sanctuary. It's also important to remember, though, the outside of the cathedral at this point. This view shows us that the dome will be visible from downtown Raleigh, just as the steeple was at one point from Holy Name of Jesus Chapel. It will remind all of us in the city of Raleigh that this cathedral is our home. Finally, as you're in the north transept from this side over here, looking across the sanctuary, this is the view that you will have. You'll notice that the sanctuary is raised about this height. Everybody will have a clear view of the altar. See closest to you on the left side, the cathedra, where the bishop will sit, the altar of sacrifice in the middle, and on the far side, the ambo, similar to as it's set up here today. You notice that large window all the way in the far transept, again, the installation of stained glass, beautiful rose windows from the Ascension of Our Lord Church in Philadelphia. What a wonderful reminder of the legacy. Coming from the south transept, looking back across the sanctuary, a similar view, closer to the ambo, and again, seeing the altar directly in the middle of the transepts and in line with the nave. Finally, as you approach the sanctuary and come about right here, this is what you will see. Clearly, you see the tabernacle and the apse and the columns surrounding the tabernacle. And this is what it may look like. For a sense of perspective, the cathedral will start there, but it continues far beyond the tent, all the way to the cross that Mr. Otwell spoke about, where the altar will be. The cathedral will be more than 5 times the size of the tent that you're in right now. But this is precisely where you will be sitting in just a few years. Holy Name of Jesus Cathedral will be a home for our diocese. It will be a place of worship and prayer, of liturgy, of diocesan celebrations and gatherings. It will be a place for people from all over the diocese, our state, all over the world to come to see the vision of Father Thomas Price at the Nazareth property realized, a home for people of faith. Today, it's interesting to imagine what it would have been like to walk this property with Father Thomas Price over 100 years ago, to marvel at his missionary zeal, his great faith, his tireless work, to wonder what he would be thinking sitting here today. We think about all of the inhabitants of this property, all of the children, all of the religious and clergy who served, all of the teachers and the students, the many people who visited this campus, the leaders of our diocese, our bishops, what they would be thinking sitting here today. But we also think about 100 years from now. When people are in our cathedral, when people think back to those of us who were sitting here at this time and in this place, and imagining what were they thinking sitting in this spot before the cathedral was built? How could they have imagined what would happen? And how, in a state where just over 100 years ago there were less than 500 Catholics in the entire state, was this beautiful cathedral built? Our answer is simple: with the grace of God and faith. Thank you.